In this video, we are going to create content of the content types basic page and also an article. In the process, we are going to compare and contrast the differences in their respective structured data, and we are briefly going to examine the settings which enable such differences. Since we have already created an article in previous videos, let's begin with creating a basic page. In the admin toolbar, select Content, Add Content, and choose Basic Page. Right from the get-go, we only have two fields to add data into, title and body. These options to the right here, revision log message, menu settings, URL alias, authoring information, and promotion options are established at the basic page content type configuration, and we'll look at those settings in just a bit. For now, over in the asset directory in another tab, browse to Unit 5 and click on the first basic page link, About Us. The title is About Us, copy and paste that into Drupal, and do the same for the body text. Copy, paste. Keep the text format as basic HTML. If you'd like to learn more about text formats, feel free to click on this About Text Formats link at any time. It will open a new tab where you can refresh your understanding. After you have entered the title and body, turn your attention to the right-hand side here. Again, these options are presented because of the way the basic page content type is configured. Let's first examine each of these options, and then we'll go investigate the content type settings to understand why we were able to do what we did. First, here in the revision log message, it's best practice to always enter text which describes the work you did. I will enter initial text. Next, here in menu settings, click to expand the options. Be sure to check Provide a Menu Link. Notice the various options here. These are mostly intuitive. The link title, a description shown when hovering, and here, importantly, under Parent Link, we can see that we can only place the menu link in the main navigation menu. Let's keep the parent link as the main navigation, meaning this link will be rendered alongside any other primary navigation links, such as Home. The weight determines the order which the links are displayed. As it says, menu links with lower weights are displayed before links with higher weights. For now, let's enter a weight of 10. Continuing on, we see that there is an option for URL alias. By default, the URL to content such as this will be /node/node ID. That default is not human friendly, so Drupal gives us an option to alias the URL. For this about page, let's enter /about-us. The authoring information section is self-explanatory. Enter the username of the content author. By default, it is the user of the currently logged in user and the authored time. The final option set of this basic page is promotion options. Again, click to expand and notice the default settings here. Both options are not selected. Promoted to front page is not selected, and sticky at top of lists is not selected. For our purposes, keep the defaults. Going back up to view the save button, notice two other settings here. We have a published option, currently selected by default, and we have a preview button. Every one of these options which we have reviewed and changed as necessary are available because of the basic page content type settings. Let's view these content type settings now. So we don't lose our work, open a new tab to Structure. Then click on Content Types. Then this can be a bit tricky. On the drop-down menu of Basic Page, open the drop-down and select Edit. If you are using the Admin Toolbar module, hover over Structure, Content Types, then click Basic Page. This is where we can configure the settings for every basic page content item. We have the name, a description which shows up on the structure content types page, and here near the bottom we have various settings. These are submission form settings, publishing options, display settings, and menu settings. Each of these controls a setting that we saw when we were creating a basic page. Here in submission form settings, we have the preview before submitting set to optional. Under publishing options, we can set the default options. In this case, basic pages will have published on by default, promoted to front page, and sticky at the top of lists are not selected by default, and the ability to create revisions is turned on. Under display settings, display author and date information is turned off by default. We'll see the effects of this after we save and publish the About Us page. Finally, there are menu settings. Expanding these settings, we can see that main navigation is the only available menu content authors have to choose from. This reflects our experience when we added the About Us link. Switching back over to the About Us creation page, let's click Save and see what happens. Remember, we are expecting to see a new main menu item appear, and that this content item will have a URL of /about-us. Clicking Save. Excellent! Sure enough, About Us is listed in the main navigation up here. And look at the URL. It does show /about-us. Nice. One thing that is not displayed is the author and date information as it is configured. Now, let's follow the same process to create an article to compare what is different in its content type configuration. For quick comparison, I am going to keep our existing tabs open. Open Content, Add Content, Article in another new tab. Just like the basic page content type, the article content type also has a title and a body field. Articles also have a field for the tag's taxonomy and an image field. Notice that articles also have save and preview buttons, and articles are intended to be published by default. On the right-hand side, we see similar option settings to that of basic pages. A place for revisions, menu settings, comment settings are new. We'll look at these in just a bit. Articles also have settings for the URL alias, authoring information, and promotion options. Note that by default, articles are selected to be promoted to the front page. So we can compare the slight differences between how article content types and basic page content types are configured. Again, in a new tab, open Structure, Content Types, then Article. Near the bottom of the page are the article option settings. Submission form settings are exactly the same as basic page. Publish options are slightly different. Here, articles are promoted to the front page by default. For articles, displaying the author and date information has been selected. And in menu settings, articles also have the ability to be added to the main navigation menu. Now, although we will go over fields in much more detail in future videos, to preview in the article content type, click on the Manage Fields tab. Here, we get an overview of all the fields that are relevant to article content items. Note that it is because of this comments field that we are presented with a comments setting option in the article creation form. Speaking of which, let's switch back over to the Create Article page. Here is the comment settings option created by the comments field we were just viewing earlier. Okay. Now let's fill in the data of this article by copying and pasting from the asset directory. It's at unit 5, number 2, article, upcoming virtual waterfall meetup. Excellent. Before we hit save, I want to highlight a couple of content authoring details. Obviously, here in the body, before publishing, as content editors, we would need to know the link to the live stream and the date of the event. The fact that these are placeholder text demonstrates the usefulness of establishing a content publishing workflow, which we will learn about later. For now, I am comfortable with keeping this provided text as is. The other point to highlight is that with taxonomy terms, when they are entered, they need to be comma separated. Because we have not entered these terms before, there is no parentheses following the term. So, for demonstrative purposes, I will enter the term blog, which is a term we used previously. Notice how parentheses appear after the term blog. This is normal, and you should not try to remove them. So follow along and also enter the term blog. Keep the options settings to the right as default. Now that we have entered in the data provided, click Save and let's see what happens. Awesome! See here that the course author and publish date are displayed, whereas with basic pages, this information was not. A bit further down, the tags are displayed, and notice that the term blog does not have parentheses next to it. Down below is the comments functionality. Notice the URL, node/some number. Your number may be different than mine depending upon if you had previously created other content items. For me, it is node/3. This 3 is what is called the node ID. Make a mental note that node IDs are frequently referenced elsewhere in Drupal. More on that later. For now, go ahead and click on the tag term blog to see what happens. Awesome! Drupal is automatically grouping and displaying all content that is tagged with the term blog. This is the power of taxonomy. One final thing to point out is demonstrated by clicking on the home link to go back to the front page. Remember, by default, Drupal displays a list of content items which have been marked to be promoted to the front page. That is why we see the upcoming virtual waterfall article and the Who Doesn't Like a Good Waterfall article listed here, but the About Us basic page is not listed. Wow, we covered a lot of material in this video. Nice work. I'll see you in the next video. Happy learning.